is around me. Trouble seems to be as close as you, even my friends and family doubt me. But I can take it, cause I take it, and give it to the Lord in prayer. I'll take it to the Lord. Try as hard as I know how, but oh, you know that's just when I make my decision. Yeah, that I can take it, cause I take it, give it to the Lord.
Celebrating our social media all-stars. We love the men and women who are helping us get the word out. Your comments make a difference. Your likes make a difference. Your shares help us spread the word. And I've got to say a special shout out, one of our newest board members who's also helping on this team, Angela Adley. Thank you so much for choosing the clips for the month of July that we are sharing socially. Join us Saturday, August 7th. It's going to be phenomenal. This is the UPCHURCH Family Reunion Picnic from noon to 4 at Blair Hills Park. You don't want to miss this. This is the first time that we're coming together since the pandemic. And I don't know about you, but I need to see you, to hug you, to let you know that I love you, and just to connect. And so we're inviting everyone, even if you live out of town, this is a great weekend to book a ticket. Come hang out with us in Los Angeles. We would love to see you. Blair Hills Park, there are more details to come. If you're interested in helping us plan the picnic, and we do need your help, please join us on Monday nights at 7. We're meeting via Zoom to put together everything. You can reach out to the church office, UPCHURCH at upchurch.org. Can't wait to see you.
And a pleasant good morning to you. Oh, I know we can do better than that. Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to Understanding Principles for Better Living. Just how are you feeling this morning? I see some of you are truly blessed. It's truly a wonderful day to praise the Lord. Are you ready to praise the Lord today? Are you ready to praise the Lord today? I know I am. Thank you so much. If you would go to that still small place as we pray to the Lord this morning. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for allowing us to breathe your air this morning, to put our 2 feet on the floor and step one step at a time. I thank you so much for that, because without that, we wouldn't be able to function. I thank you for your healing powers as you are healing my voice right now. I thank you, Father, for your peace, your love, your understanding. Can I get you to say, I thank you, Father. I thank you, Father. Oh, we thank you this morning for this ministry. We thank you for that which it teaches us each and every day. And we thank you for the opportunity to walk in your footsteps as we teach and preach every day, because that's our job. That is our job, to shine for you and to show the world what you are in our lives. We thank you for that opportunity today. Oh, we thank you for that opportunity. I ask that you might continue to bless us, Father, as we continue to go further, as we continue to swell as a congregation and as a church, because we have a message to send to the world. And it's your message, and it's important that we do so. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to bless this entire world. You know the state that it's in, and we know that it needs some fixing. This government of ours needs some fixing, and we know that you can help us do that. We ask that you might continue to bless each and every soul that had a hard time getting out of bed this morning. And we bless those that went on to be with you today. We thank you for all these blessings, and we say, and so it is, and amen. I want to thank you, Lord. Oh, oh, I just want to thank you, Lord. Oh, oh, I just want to thank you, Lord. Can I get your church to say a big amen? Amen. Amen. Can I get you to stand as we sing the Lord's Prayer? Say, I love you today just like God loves me.
Wasn't that good? Wasn't that just delicious? Thank you so much, Bob Henley. I'm Reverend Sherri James, and I'm the senior minister of this growing global community. This month, we're giving you a taste of vintage UPCHURCH. So all of these different clips are just from our archives, and our archives are rich, absolutely rich. That clip that you just saw was how we used to open the service, and I thought that it was a wonderful way to start today's service. So I want to welcome you in. Come on in, get comfortable. Couple of housekeeping things. If you are joining us for the first time, or if you haven't done this, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Go ahead, hit that button, set yourself up to receive notifications. Make sure that you like this video, you share it with a friend, and then, you know, leave us a comment. All those things make a difference, and we really, really deeply appreciate it. And I'm always in there during the week making sure that I respond to your comments, because I do appreciate them, and I love the things that you guys share, whether they're testimonies or just a hand up and an amen. All that makes a difference. If you are watching us on Facebook, please like our Facebook page. Make sure you share this video in your timeline. Let more people know about UPCHURCH. And also, same thing, set yourself up to receive those notifications. All right, wonderful. Well, the opening prayer has been done. I'm gonna share with you the vision for this ministry. Our vision is to love every person up to their true identity and to their highest potential for the greater good of all. We are on a mission to express God's divine love through teaching spiritual principles, worship services, fellowship activities, and community outreach. And our theme this year is Open Your Mind. Open Your Mind. And the sermon today will be given by my spiritual mother, the Reverend Dr. Della Reese Lett. And her sermon today is on forgiveness. It is on forgiveness. Part of opening your mind, sometimes what interferes with the opening of the mind is how cluttered it is with the things that we haven't forgiven. And so this is an opportunity for you to revisit that topic. Maybe it's something you got a little button on, but you can revisit it as Reverend Della shares with you why you must forgive in order to grow and to have all the good that God has for you.
Peace and blessings, UPCHURCH family. I'm Reverend Sheree Thompson, and I am here to say welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome to UPCHURCH. You come into UPCHURCH at such a fun time. We are celebrating our 35th anniversary, and we have been celebrating our wonderful legacy, rich tradition, by showing some of our classic UPCHURCH choir videos, and also just loving some of the sermons, some of the word that came from Reverend Della. So great time to click into UPCHURCH. I want you to know that we have a rich legacy that we have continued to expand and unfold. And so the UPCHURCH today is stronger and mightier than ever. We are completely focused on spiritual growth. And so if you find that you're ready to grow spiritually and you're looking for a community to come and grow spiritually with, I want you to consider UPCHURCH. Join UPCHURCH today. All that you need to do is let us know you're interested. Just email us at upchurch@upchurch.org, or you can call the church office and we'll give you your next step. What's most important is that you know that right now is such a great time to begin to say yes, God, to unfold spiritually, to allow what's good, what's whole, what's perfect within you to come into full expression. Now, I want you to know that this is a loving community that we're growing in, and I want you to know who you're worshiping with. And so if I can get the church family, those who are our friends, our frequent visitors, everybody join in on this. I want you to introduce one another to each other by your spiritual name. And so all that you do is you take a quality of God, right? So get one in your mind right now, and then you put your I am next to it. So I'll go first. I am love. What's your spiritual name? I want you to go ahead and write that in the chat. I want you to speak it out loud. I want you to put it in the comments. I want you to say it really loud and proud. What is your spiritual name? Who are you really? And I want you to pick something that really you want to experience more of, that you want to bring from within into your life, world, and affairs. And so it is so wonderful to get to know you this way, UPCHURCH family. I want you to know that today you're going to hear something that I know is going to knock your socks off. I know you're going to hear exactly what you needed for the breakthrough that you've been praying for. So open up your heart and mind to receive the divine word that's coming through song, that's coming through the word. And I just trust, I can't wait to see you as you have arisen and broken through whatever's been holding you back. We're going to have our daily inspiration for better living, and then I'll be back with you for the affirmation of power.
Take action. Inspire change. Today is Nelson Mandela International Day. Established in recognition of the former South African president's contribution to the culture of peace and freedom throughout the world. Everyone has the ability and responsibility to change the world for better. And Mandela Day is a wonderful opportunity to take action and inspire change by making a difference in our communities. In his words, we should all ask ourselves, what have I done to improve the surroundings in which I live? Do I litter or do I protect my surroundings? Do I buy stolen goods or do I help reduce crime? We can take action and inspire change by getting to know someone from a different cultural background. Mutual understanding can rid communities of widespread prejudice and xenophobia. Providing meals for people living on the street, donating tablets for children in under-resourced schools are ways in which we can make a better world for one and all. Hebrews 13:16. Do not forget to do good and to help one another.
This issue of the Daily Inspiration is just so wonderful. So we've had an opportunity to listen to the word, to listen and be inspired. Now we're going to use the power of our spoken word to tell ourselves the truth about ourselves. And so the affirmation of power this month, I chose because it was one of Reverend Della's favorites. She often gave this to us to remind us that we live, move, and have our being in God's perfect, divine, radiant substance. And so I'm going to actually ask you to read this affirmation, to affirm this with me, and let's do it together. The Lord is my banker. My credit is good. He makes me lie down in the consciousness of omnipresent abundance. He gives me the key to his strong box. He restores my faith in his riches. He guides me in the paths of prosperity for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk in the very shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Thy gold and thy silver, they secure me. You prepare a way for me in the presence of the collector. You fill my wallet with plenty. My measure runs over. Surely goodness and plenty will follow me all the days of my life, and I shall do business in the name of the Lord forever. And so it is. What a mighty adaptation of the 23rd Psalm that we are right now affirming together. This was written by Charles Fillmore in his powerful text called Prosperity. And so I want you to work with that affirmation of power, even if you just take one line from it. The Lord is my banker, my credit is good. Maybe you need to work with that as we move forward throughout the week. Maybe you need to remember that goodness and mercy and plenty shall follow you all the days of your life. Maybe you need to be reminded that you must do business in the name of the Lord. So take this affirmation and work with it throughout the week. Allow yourself to expand the dynamic prosperity consciousness that is right now waiting to unfold through you. We have another special segment coming up. It's called Honoring Our Roots. Now, I told you before that this is our 35th anniversary. And so we have all of these wonderful, wonderful throwbacks and surprises throughout the service. So enjoy this opportunity to honor our rich legacy. God bless you. Have a beautiful rest of your day.
Wow, 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 wow. Good morning, Understanding Principles. Welcome to the best day of your life. To our visitors, we welcome you. Thank you for joining us. Will you please stand so that we may acknowledge you? And when you have received your gift, you may be seated. Thank you for choosing to spend your Sunday morning with us here at Understanding Principles for Better Living Church. We appreciate you, and we want you to know that we want you to come back. There is power in this church, power to heal, power to prosper, power to overcome whatever you're dealing with. During the month of May, we celebrate the spiritual faculty of power. And last week we said that power is man's innate control over his thoughts and feelings. Whether you act like it or not, you have control over your thoughts and feelings. And all those thoughts and feelings that came up out of the blue, well, there is no blue. If it showed up, you put it there or you allowed it to be there sometime or another. The disciple that represents the power faculty of the mind is Philip, and the color we associate with power is purple. So when you see purple, remind yourself that you have authority and dominion over any thoughts and feelings that come up in your life. When you see purple, remind yourself that there is no blue. God doesn't give you power so that you can make other people do what you want them to do. That is the misapplication of power. God gives you power so that you can first gain control of yourself and then can gain control over the ideas that he has endowed you with and expects you to carry out. When you master yourself and the ideas that God has given you, phrases like out of the blue leave your vocabulary. You recognize that there are no accidents. The power faculty expresses its dominion from the throat. It controls all the vibratory energies of the body. It is the open door between the formed and the formless. In other words, the words that come out of your mouth has power, and they can either open the door to your good or close it. Proverbs 18:21, death and life are in the power of the tongue. In other words, consider what you say. You have the ability to open your life up or shut it down by the words that come out of your mouth. Through the vibrations of the power in the throat, you can feel the power of your oneness with God more quickly than in any other way. The voice is the most direct avenue of this expression. Jesus in Matthew 4:4 says, "One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God." The power of love makes the voice rich, warm, and mellow. You know how your voice sounds when you're talking about somebody that you love. Your words take on an energy or a rhythm that is unmistakable. Well, love is what draws to you your good. And if you're going to have the life you envision, you must love it before it shows up. You must speak over your life using words of love. And in doing this, you marry the spiritual faculty of love with the spiritual faculty of power. And that power faculty swings open all the doors of mind and body. So before you speak, consider what you will say, for surely it will create. When we understand this power, we have the key to why the sacred writings in the Bible have stood the test of time. Every word that man utters makes an imprint in the substance, in the astral ethers. Every word creates. And when there is a consciousness of God in the mind of the speaker, all of the words become living entities and are perpetuated. And anyone who develops sufficient spiritual power can do this. Don't take for granted that every February we repeat the words of Dr. Martin Luther King, "I have a dream today." Do you think that's an accident? Developing your power is about connecting with God. Your power is cultivated through the words that come out of your mouth. When you get dialed into your source, your Alpha and your Omega, everything you create sticks. You can build churches that last for 20 plus years. You can build marriages that last for 50 plus years. You can erect companies that stand for generations. Developing your power gives you the ability to create forms that don't require you to be there in order to sustain them. The words you spoke when you built them were sufficient to keep them going long after you've transitioned out of this life form. When your words are imbued with the power of spirit, they have the power to move multitudes, and they are not constrained by the conditions of time. When you speak from the inner core, the real you, the place from which healing words emanate, your words feed the souls of men, and they are creative as well as recreative. How do people feel when they leave your presence? Are they lifted up, or have the words that have come out of your mouth brought them down? Consider what you say. The word of truth has life in it. It has power to restore and make whole. It cannot perish or grow less with time. And the more spiritual the individual is who speaks the words, the more enduring and the more powerfully they move men. So what are you saying? Are you speaking from your inner truth? Or are you repeating the lyrics to the latest song? Are the words that are coming out of your mouth full of love and life? Or are they full of pain and powerlessness? Will the masses continue to repeat what you say because you took the time to develop your spiritual power, or will your words fade away into nothingness? Are you speaking words that deserve to be repeated? Or are you misusing your power and speaking words that cannot help but draw to you sickness, poverty, and despair? The control lies with you. Whatever you say will be, will be. We have an opening statement. It's printed in your bulletin. I'll read it first and then we'll say it together. I am one with God. I am one with all men. I am one with all life. I am one with the one. Together, I am one with God. I am one with all men. I am one with all life. I am one with the one. God bless you.
Can y'all see how hard we used to jam? Oh my God, when I saw that on camera, some things you forget, time moves on. And so that's the beauty of these vintage archives. They take you back. And I forgot how much it was like a battle of the instruments, and seeing Mark and Tom battle with the horn and the sax. Oh, that was everything. That was everything. Oh my goodness. You guys are in for such a treat. You are in for such a treat. You've heard Reverend Sheree and me talk about forgiveness and the value and the importance of it. We've done whole series on letting go, on just releasing so that you can have what the Spirit has prepared for you. You know, there's good that's there for you that you ought to have. But it's one thing to hear it from us, it's another thing to hear where we got it from. And so I really want you to take in this lesson on forgiveness. Now, I have to tell you, the song after the sermon gets cut off. So I want to warn you about that in advance. The song starts, she sings, and she gets almost to the end, and I guess they ran out of tape. So I just want to give you a heads up in advance. But the weight of what you are about to take in cannot be overstated. Forgiveness is the way that you allow more good into your experience. You have to let it go. You really genuinely have to let it go. And you have to forgive it and forget it. You know, some people will say, well, you know, I forgive, but I won't forget. Well, then you haven't forgiven. Because forgiveness creates or includes its own protection. And so I want to encourage you to forgive it, forget it, and let it go. All right, passing the baton to my spiritual mom, Reverend Della.
I got this. The KCACTF region number 8. For acting excellence in the Santa Monica College production of Kiss of the Spider Woman, the Kennedy Center American College Theater Festival, Region 8, Board of the Governors proclaims John Downey III to be an Irene Ryan Scholarship nominee for the 208 Irene Ryan Scholarship auditions. I love that. So I absolutely, I just, it's proof that if you follow the principles, you can do what you want. This is what he wants to do.
That's right.
This is all he wants to do.
That's right.
Now, he's had jobs as a producer. Mm-hmm. He's had jobs doing other things. And he's successful in each one of them. But this is what he wants to do.
Right.
And every time he does it, it's better and better.
Right.
Turns me on. I don't care if it don't turn you on.
Yeah. Yeah.
It turns me on. Metaphysics is a word that hangs people up. So I'm going to talk to you a little bit about that. Metaphysics is the systematic study of the science of being. By pure metaphysics is meant to give a clear understanding of the realm of ideas and their legitimate expression. Meta means beyond, M-E-T-A. Physical, physics. So physics, physical. So what metaphysics is, looking beyond your physical body, looking beyond your physical understanding, looking beyond your physical feelings, but getting to the spirit of you. The spirit of you is who is made in the image likeness of God, not this body. You see, look at us. We all look different. So we can't, even though some of us are related, we still look different. So understand that what Jesus was here for was to teach us that there's a better us. there's one made in the image likeness of God. Are we understanding that so far? All right. A metaphysician is one skilled in the science of being, a student and a teacher of the law of spirit. Ephesians 3:16 says this, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man, your spiritual self, in the inner man, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, and that ye, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth, the length, the depth, and the height, and to know the love of Christ, which passes knowledge, that you might be filled with the fullness of God. So it's all that we're teaching here is to go beyond this physical, because your physical is what gets sick. Your physical is what gets hungry, gets tired, gets weary. We want to go behind that, because beyond that is the spiritual you who is never tired. Huh? Never afraid, never sick. So that's where we're trying to go. That's what these teachings about. And I have to pray a lot, because people misunderstanding that word cut themselves off from getting to their real selves. Metaphysics deals with consciousness. And consciousness is your sum total of inner awareness. What you are consciously aware of is what's inside of you. Hello? Okay? So we are dealing here with conscious awareness, with the inner you, the Christ inside of you. Okay? Metaphysics is about the real you, about the inner you. You see, John 7:24 says this, judge not according to the appearance, but judge righteous judgment. The outer of each of us is just an appearance. The outer of you change your appearance every day. Some of you change it 5-6 times a day. You have your work clothes. You have your play clothes. You have your dinner clothes. You have your suntan suit. Huh? You have your old funky robe that you like to lay around in. Huh? Your scrubby pants. Each time you change an appearance. Your appearance. An outer thing, not an inner thing. Okay? All right. Consciousness is the sum total of your inner awareness. That's why we keep talking to you about thinking right thoughts. Because if you're consciously aware of the right, it's just about impossible for you to get off the track. What gets you off the track is you forget. That was the first and original sin. Adam and Eve forgot. So you forget, and then there you are. You understand. Spiritual understanding is a revelation of truth, of your spiritual birth. With these thoughts and these attitudes that I've just talked to you about, we're going to celebrate Christmas in 3 lesson sermons. We're going to get a metaphysical understanding of the Christian experience. Not only the outer materialistic approach, but also the real meaning, the real understanding of this experience, so that we will know how to experience it every day. Not just the 25th day of December. Okay? We start today, and for the next 3 weeks, we're going to study the real meaning of Christmas. On the 23rd, the Sunday before Christmas, we will have, as usual, our magnificent choir and orchestra and Doc's birthday and Buffy's birthday, and we will celebrate in that manner. I want this to be the greatest Christmas you've ever known, and so we're going to get into the real Christmas, because you understand, when you understand, you go forward. See, you have new verve, you have new zeal, and so you won't be going into the new year writing down little things. thank you so much. I'm going to keep you and Doc from standing outside my window when I'm doing my work. It was wonderful. Everything you said was absolute truth.
Yeah.
And thank you for saying it. I'm glad to see the young people step up and say what needs to be done. Now, I have a few questions on the subject. Answer them for you. You don't have to answer them for me. Through divine imagination, our lives bear much fruit. Will your divine imagination prepare your fruit for your table this Christmas? Will your own individual divine imagination prepare your table? Are you ready for the baby Jesus? Are you ready for the perfect man? God's idea of man, the I am, the divine understanding, the spiritual awareness, your deliverance, your salvation, your safety, your prosperity, and your constant help. Are you ready for that? That's what the baby said. Isaiah said that's the way the baby gonna be. Are you ready for that kind of baby? You have to conceive this spiritual awareness intuitively. You see, divine understanding is conceived in the intuition or the soul nature and molded into substance. Mary, metaphysically, represents intuition. Divine understanding is conceived in the intuition or the soul nature and then molded into substance. Mary intuitively believed the angel. She had no proof. In fact, it looked like if she ever said that to anybody, they were going to have her committed because she must be crazy because don't no angels come down and talk to you. Do you hear me what I'm saying? Huh? He's going to have to come through your intuition and your imagination too. The coming of the Christ into activity in your life is the result of an exalted idea sown in your mind and nurtured by your soul, by the Mary of you. Is it okay, so? So what we need to be working on first is the Mary in us. You see, our listening.
Yes, yes.
Listening to our intuition.
Yes.
Using our imagination.
Yes.
Experiencing the wondrousness of God daily in the temple. That's what Mary did.
Yeah.
Daily in the temple.
Yeah.
Not the church.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
In the temple.
Yeah.
Daily in the temple.
Yeah.
Listening to my intuition.
Yeah.
Using my imagination.
Yeah.
Getting ready for the baby.
Yeah.
Huh? Okay. Second question, how are you decorating the inside of your home? Not your house. Not your house. Your home. How are you decorating the inside of your home? The inside of you is the temple of God. Huh? And the law is, as within, so without. So, is your star the star of spiritual illumination? Do you have a star? What kind of star do you have? Don't answer me. Answer you. Okay. That night there was a bright shining in the darkness. Huh? That revealed the truth. Do you have a star in your home? In the darkness, revealing the truth. Jesus is called the bright and morning star, the light that endures through the night and is still shining when the morning comes. Do you have that kind of light? Is the star shining and leading you along the Christian route? Huh? The tree is the connecting link between earth and heaven. Your thinking that is rooted in the earth reaches towards the heaven, toward the spiritual you. And you don't have to believe me. You've been through something. And you felt like, I don't know how I'm going to get through this. And you did everything you thought you knew how to do. But it came to that point when you finally accepted, I need some help. You never been there. Our soul in here has ever had a problem. Are we in the Spirit of God in here? Well, isn't that magnificent? Well, take from my life, I've had several problems. You too. Oh, how wonderful. Okay. You see, your thinking that is rooted in the earth, rooted in this body. You see, and understand how your thinking is shaded by this body. You wake up and your head hurts. You give it to her. You don't give her a headache. You make her pay for your headache. So now she's feeling bad because she's paying for your headache, but she doesn't know it's your headache she's paying for, which is very confusing. The other side, I haven't done anything. Why? Just went off on me. I don't know why she just went off on me. Huh? So we're trying to reach up out of this thinking. We're trying to reach up higher, so that when I wake up with a headache, I have sense enough to say, in the name of Christ Jesus, you will have to leave here. You cannot stay here. I have nothing in me to feed a false growth. You will leave me alone right now. So when you get to her, hey, baby, what's happening this morning? Okay. See, is your tree an evergreen or is it plastic? What kind of tree you got? Huh? Are your prayers and your communications to and with God true or are they phony? Do you only run that when you need something? See, I didn't have what you call a family. I had some people born of my mother. And they did not make it as well as I made it. But they never called me to say, how do you feel? They never called to say, can there something I can do for you? The only time when the phone rang and Shirley or Franklin said their name, I knew they wanted some money. Now, there was a whole lot of conversation before they got to, could you let me have some money? You understand? Which was really made me more than them angrier than them asking me for the money. Don't waste my time. You know what you want. When I pick up the phone, say what you want. If I'm going to send it, I'll send it. If I'm not, I'm not. Goodbye. But I got to stay on the phone with you and listen to all your troubles and your confusion. Huh? Mm-hmm. That's a plastic tree. That's a plastic prayer. That's not a true prayer. You see, because if they had been family to me, they would never have had to ask me for anything because I'm a giver. And I would have just sent it. You see, huh? I know you have nobody like that surrounding you. But if you do, you know, if you know somebody who has somebody like that surrounding them, it's because they're all human, they believe. And they respond to all humanness because that's who they believe they are. They never get to the real them. What we want to do this Christmas is get to the real deal, you see. What are your ornaments on your tree? Is one of them faith in God? Do you have a faith in God ornament?
Yes.
Four got a faith. I got a big faith in God ornament. I have. Oh, yes. Because I've had to use it so many times. See, you may not know about it because you just told me you never had any trouble. So you never had to stand on your faith. See, I've been hungering out of doors in the snow. And so I had to have some faith for somebody to get me out of the snow and give me something to eat. I walked through a plate glass window. I had 1,000 stitches and lost 7 pints of blood. I don't have but 9. So I had to have faith. I had to have faith that God would sew me back up and start me out again. My brain exploded. I was supposed to be dead before I hit the floor. That was in 1979. My faith brought me this far. My faith picked me up off the floor. So I know about Christmas. All over my tree got faith ornaments on the tree. Huh? See, faith is more than just mere belief. Faith working in a spiritual substance accomplishes stuff you wouldn't even believe. Patience is one of the things it accomplishes. You see, we talk about waiting on God. Well, you ain't gotta have nothing but God. That's all you gotta have. That's it. God as your Father and the Christ inside of you, Jesus the Christ inside of you, leading you and guiding you and instructing you, and the Holy Spirit got your back. That's all you need. That's absolutely all you need. Patience is the bearing of stuff. See, this is a perfect time to help the people in the street, the man at the cleaners, the lady at the grocery store, the lady at the drug store, all the people that you do business with. You can help them with patience. I meant to tell you about that too, and I will. Yesterday, I went to an award-giving situation, and they gave me this scroll, the Golden Star Halo Award for Della Reese, actress, singer, lifetime achievement for outstanding contribution to the entertainment industry. They gave me this award, the Emerald Award for Della Reese, actress and singer, for your contributions to the entertainment industry and or the performing arts, December the 1st, 2007. Now, that was wonderful that they gave that to me. I really do appreciate that. But I want to tell you, I had to reach in and get my faith and wrap it all around. Because the people were not the people who were giving me the prize. The people, they loved me. They wanted to have a personal contact with me, which I don't have a problem with at all. I understand. You feed me. You buy all these fantastic things that I want. My fans do that. I'm not a dumb. So if you want to talk to me, I got time to talk to you. If I don't want to talk to you, I got a gate in front of my house and doors all around. I go in there and close my door and I don't have to talk to nobody. But yesterday, I had to call on my faith because, excuse me, doctor, I just got to talk to you. I just seen you. I seen you on Touch by an Angel. I just love you so much because I seen you. You appreciate me. Thank you. Thank you so much. Wait just a minute. Stop right there. Stop right there. I got to talk to you. I've been looking at you all the time. Oh, this is pretty. Let me have my dress back, please. Thank you very much. Patience. The man who was giving it leaned over and shook his head, looked at me and said, I mean, you're a patient one. He took it upon himself to tell the people, let the lady eat her lunch. This is my table. And I don't want you leaning all over my table. So go sit down and let her eat. Do you think that made any difference at all? It did not. And so for 3 hours, Mike was there. For 3 hours. I was so tired when I got home. I was supposed to do something with Shirley. I walked into a Sheree. I said, Shirley, I can't do nothing. I'm going to my room. I have to have some quiet. I can't stand it. You need a patience ornament on your tree. Because this is the time to see everybody mad. Everything costs too much. Huh? In a hurry. Don't let me leave that out. Thank you very much. So you're going to have to learn how to be patient. You're going to learn how to bear provocation and annoyance, misfortune, pain. You see, without complaining. Patience also is the ability, the willingness to suppress restlessness or annoyance when you're confronted with a delay. I needed that this week. I got on the phone and I ordered something. But I ordered the wrong size. I loved everything I ordered. I simply wanted to change the size. And I was feeling very good about it because it's the size that I usually order, and it was too big. And I don't mean it was a little too big, it was just drooping. Just was too much room here. Well, I'm very happy to call, so I'm calling in the Christmas mood. I want to give you my number, I give you my this, I give you my that. And I want you to understand, I love everything I got. It's just too big for me. And I'd like to return it for a smaller size. Amen. She said, well, you know your phone, your call's going to be edited for teaching and whatever else. I said, that's fine. That's all right. You can do that. I just simply want to change the size. How would you suggest that I do that? Well, I have to tell you that your call is going to be edited. Because if I don't tell you that, then they be looking at me because I, hey, edit the call. It's okay. I simply want to get a smaller size of the same item. I don't know if we still have that. Well, look. Would it be better if I just sent these back and reordered? Well, if you already got them, I don't know why you're going to keep. Hey, I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to free you from this phone. And if I need to, I will call back later. People out there make you want to kill them. It's some people that out there that will walk up to you and say, hit me in the face. And you say, no, I don't want to hit you in the face. Oh, yeah, you're going to hit me in the face, or I'm going to hit you in your face. Somebody going to get hit in the face. That's what they're going to do. That's when you have to have your patient faith ornament on your tree. You see, it's necessary for you to keep quiet inside, be steady inside, to persevere inside, to be tempered inside, to be caring, diligent. Those are the things that you have to do. Those are the things that we give the people at this time who don't know how to live. So you're standing in a line, and somebody is mad about something else and takes it out on the cashier. When you get up to the cashier, I got those cards for you. Please take some of them home. Say, you know what? I saw what happened just now, and I want to thank you. I thought you handled that so well because they shouldn't have taken that out on you. It's not your fault they didn't have turkey bacon. You did. I thought you did wonderfully well. And I appreciate what you do. I appreciate what you do. And may I give you this? And the card says, thank you for being who you are and doing what you do, because what you do is so important. Huh? You can go and clean it up.
Well, who am I to clean up?
You're supposed to be the Son of God in whom he's well pleased. That's who you're supposed to be. I don't know who you really are. Only you know that. How about believing in God's word? Do you have an ornament like that? A believing in God's word ornament? Are you still judging? Huh? Are you still judging? The scripture says, judge not that you be not judged. For with what judgment you judge, you shall be judged. And with what measure you meet, it shall be measured to you again. That's Matthew 7 and 1. Do you understand that you cannot afford to be judging people is dumb? See, because they don't understand you, they dumb. Could it possibly be that they're not dumb, but you're not making clear your situation? Maybe the dumb is on your side of the ledger. Maybe if you made it clearer, I could understand it better. How about the joy of his love? You got an ornament like that? Yeah. Mm-hmm. The awareness of his presence inside of you. You got an ornament like that? Huh. John 10 and 30. I and my Father are one. John 10, 38. If I do not the works of my Father, believe me not. But if I do, though ye believe not me, believe the works, that ye may know and believe that the Father is in me and I in him. Okay? So if you can't give them Christian conversation, because they don't want to hear Christian, and they don't have to hear it if they don't want to, but you can give them so much of you, so much of the God inside of you, so much of the love inside of you, You should be able to go in and in the middle of the argument, just stand there and in the name of God, create peace. You say you're following Jesus. That's what Jesus did all the time. So if you're following Jesus, you ought to be able to bring in some peace. You shouldn't be the person bringing in the argument and the confusion and the trouble.
Come on.
I live in the Father, and the Father lives in me. That's what Jesus kept saying that all the time. He kept saying it all the time. It wasn't because he didn't know it. Jesus had to grow. You see? And he had to keep telling himself. Like, you have to keep telling yourself. He had to keep telling himself, the Father and I are one. I'm not going off on this. The Father and I are one. He'll handle it. The Father and I are one. It's all in control. I don't have to worry about this. You have to keep telling yourself that. The same way, just like he had to do, you see. Right. Knowing these things, all of which give you peace of mind, you see. Are these your decorations? Do you have a forgiveness ornament on your tree? You need that one. You need that one. Badly. You need that one maybe more than all the rest of them. Because people in their anxiousness and their anger without their peace of mind will do things to you. You see, that will try to disrupt your peace. And instead of letting them disrupt your peace, you're supposed to bring in the peace. You see, that you say you're following Jesus Christ. I'm just telling you what Jesus did. So how are you decorating the outside of your home? Got a smile on your face? Is there a feeling of oneness with God and all men and all life? Do you transfer that into action? Do you go around blessing people? Giving them smiles and happiness? When people look at you, will they see the Christ in you? Or some old evil nuda? I didn't say it, I just made a noise. I did not say it, just made a little funny noise. Will there be less of you and more of God present in your demeanor during this great season? Did you invite the wise men? Do your wise men have enough frankincense and myrrh and gold? Do they come from the inside of you, from the east? Frankincense means free expression. Are you freely expressing the real you? Well, you better get to work on it, because that's what you're going to have to do. The real you is so wonderful. I just can hardly wake up to pass out all this good. That's me. I'm so serious. I'm about what you sow, you reap.
Yes.
I'm passing it out.
Amen.
Have some. Whoop. Yeah. Get some. What?
Happy New Year.
Kisses all over your body. Joy and love. Peace. I called a lady back, not the lady I just told you about. Another lady was very nice on the phone. And I had sent her to look for something that I later found out I already had. So I called her back and I told her, please stop looking, because I have made the mistake and I have found what I thought you didn't say. And there was this long silence. And I said, are you there? Are you there? She said, yes, ma'am, and I've been here for about 8 years, and nobody's ever called me back.
Wow.
Huh? 8 years? But somebody other than me made a mistake in 8 years. I ain't the only one making mistakes, honey. I don't believe ain't nobody else made no mistake in 8 years. She said, yes, ma'am, I'm here, and I've been here about 8 years, and nobody has ever called me back. She said, I don't know what to say. I said, well, you don't have to say anything. I'm the one who have to apologize. Huh? You can do it? You can do it? It ain't no biggie. You can do it. You see? Are your shepherds coming? Hmm? Are your shepherds coming? You got shepherds coming?
I do.
Yeah? Your shepherds represent watchfulness. They represent protecting thoughts in your mind. Protecting thoughts when you earnestly seek to get in touch with God and know how to live and to know how to use the truth. Have you got your glory to God ready? Two people. Will those two meet with me later? Because I got my glory to God ready. And we can turn it on in here. Three glory to God. He said, wherever two were together in his name, there'll be three of us or two of you. I mean, we'll glory to God up in here. You better get you some if you ain't got none. Are you ready for the power of the highest to overshadow you?
Yes.
Yes. Hmm? Are you ready to give birth to your individual demonstration of perfection? That's what the baby was. That's what Mary gave birth to. Perfection. Is your baby perfect? Are you ready to give yourself to the embodiment of all divine ideas such as intelligence and life and love and substance and strength? Or are you aborting the baby with limited comprehension and power? Well, how am I doing that? By seeing the world about you under the material law and agreeing with it and making yourself a part of it. You see, each of us has within us the Christ. And we must look within to recognize and realize our sonship. You see, our divine origin, as Jesus did, we have to discover. I wish I could think of the scripture, but they said that Jesus grew in knowledge and strength. Strength and wisdom. You've got to grow in strength. If Jesus had to do it, guess what, kitty? You've got to get your home together for Christmas. You see, you've got to get your actions in order. You've got to manifest. You've got to give birth. So as to become the true sons of God, what are you giving God and the ones you love? See, the wise men gave all the gifts to God.
You didn't have to say that, Dale. I got to give my wife some. I got to cheer in. I got to give to cheer in.
God gave you your husband. God gave you your wife and your cheering. Now, so what are you going to give to God? for your wife and your children, or your husband and your children. The wise men gave the gifts to Jesus. I have some suggestions. Yeah, go shop, buy cute things. But try giving your family your heart. Try giving them some love, some real love. Try giving God your soul and your mind. Huh? Try giving God your body and your being. Try giving God the spirit of your life. To your family, will your gifts be a good attitude? A kind mouth? A helping hand? Some trust? Some appreciation? Give them the warmth of the Christ inside of you. Don't just keep taking and don't appreciate and don't give them nothing. If not, you're not getting ready for Christmas, really. You're just going through the motions. But there's still time to get ready for a real Christmas. Think about it. This year, why don't you celebrate Christmas in the name and nature of Jesus Christ? Huh? Why don't you let all the magnificence that is good coming up through you to you bless everybody you meet this season? That's why I put that slip in there for you in the bulletin. Realize who you are and share the wondrousness of who you are. Some people will never read a Bible, but you can give them so much love that they will follow you to the church. Wait, yesterday I didn't have enough cards. Where is your church? Where is your church? I won't come to your church. And I'm saying, where it is, and I'm saying, Sawtell and Olympic, and they came so fast, Franklin said, you ought to say Olympic first, the address is on Olympic. Say Olympic first. I say Olympic, Sawtell, Sawtell, Olympic, Olympic, Sawtell. Sawtell, Olympic, Olympic, Sawtell. Well, we just got to come up. One lady said, what kind of church do you have? Is it a Christian church? I said, well, I teach the principles of Jesus Christ. Is that Christian? Her husband said, yeah, B, I think that's Christian. The people that went away yesterday do not know how nearly they frustrated me because I gave them the God inside of me. And they took that home with them wherever they are at this time. If they're talking to somebody, this, and I was with Della Reese yesterday, and do you know I just pulled on and everything. She didn't say a thing. She was just so sweet. And she took my picture, and I took her picture with her, and I just. They're not going to always say, well, I tried to talk to that hussy, and she didn't have nothing to say. And they may have been, huh? I'm representing Christ Jesus. There are requirements to representing Christ Jesus. You have those requirements also, and you should be doing us. I want you to start forgiving all that stuff you're holding inside of you. Start forgiving it. Get a clean inside. Hello? Get a clean inside. Get a clean inside so that you can serve him this Christmas, so you can be what you're supposed to be this Christmas. Don't be carrying a grudge from before into now. Let it go. Forgive it. Forget it. Let it pass you by. Forgive it. Forget it. Don't even bother to wonder why. Don't give this junk your attention. Forget it was even meant. Forgive it. Forget it. Let it pass you by. You're too good. You're too filled with God to give out anything but love and peace and joy. So forget all the rest of that stuff. Forgive it. Forget it. Let it pass you by. Forgive it. Forget it. Don't bother to wonder why. Don't give it your attention. Forget it was even mentioned. Forgive it. Forget it. And let it. I say that you should forgive it. Forget it. Let it pass you by. Forgive it.
Forget it. Don't bother to wonder why. Give it your attention. Forget it was even mentioned. Forgive it. Forget it. And let it. This is why. When Jesus hung upon the cross, everybody thought that his life was lost. He looked down from the cross at the crowd, and then the Savior cried out loud, forgive them, Father, they know not what they do. While he was hanging there, he gave this lesson to you. He said that you ought to forgive it, forget it, let it pass you by. Forgive it, forget it. Don't bother to wonder why. Don't give it your attention. Forget it was even mentioned. Forgive it, forget it, and let it pass you by. You know, Peter asked this question one day of our Lord. Matthew, standing by, recorded his word. Forgiving my brother 7 times, will that do? No, Peter, heed what I say to you. 70 times, 7 times, forgive. Because that's the way our Lord wants us to live. Yes, just forgive it, forget it, let it pass you by. Forgive it, forget it. Don't bother to wonder why. Don't give it your attention. Forget it will even mention. Forget it, and let it. Now there are things in life that will cause you pain, but it's left up to you if the pain remains. Don't keep a place where hurt can live. Obey the Lord and just forgive. As we forgive each other, our Father forgives us. Oh, if it was forgiveness, forgive we must. What we've got to do is forgive it, forget it, let it pass you by.
All right, family, now is the time to set the law of giving and receiving into action for yourself. Understanding Principles. You can text the word UPCHURCH to 73256 to complete your gift. You can use Cash App. Our Cash App ID is $UPCHURCHLA. You can also go to our website, upchurch.org, choose the button Give Online. And finally, the mail still works. You can mail your gift to Understanding Principles, 600 West Queen Street, Inglewood, California, 90301. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. I give in love and I trust God. All right, let's add a declaration with that. I am in the flow. I give generously and I receive lavishly. My Father, Mother, God supplies all my needs. I am divinely supplied. All right, family, thank you so much for your support. Let's have some announcements and then I'll be back to close this out. Join us Saturday, August 7th. It's going to be phenomenal. This is the UPCHURCH Family Reunion Picnic from noon to 4 at Blair Hills Park. You don't want to miss this. This is the first time that we're coming together since the pandemic. And I don't know about you, but I need to see you, to hug you, to let you know that I love you, and just to connect. And so we're inviting everyone, even if you live out of town, this is a great weekend to book a ticket. Come hang out with us in Los Angeles. We would love to see you. Blair Hills Park, there are more details to come. If you're interested in helping us plan the picnic, and we do need your help, please join us on Monday nights at 7. We're meeting via Zoom to put together everything. You can reach out to the church office, UPCHURCH at upchurch.org. Can't wait to see you. Join me in celebrating our social media all-stars. We love the men and women who are helping us get the word out. Your comments make a difference. Your likes make a difference. Your shares help us spread the word. And I've got to say a special shout out, one of our newest board members who's also helping on this team, Angela Adley. Thank you so much for choosing the clips for the month of July that we are sharing socially.
I don't need nobody else.
What a beautiful service today was. So many delightful elements. I was joking with Sheree when we were going through the archives and seeing these old images of ourselves. And it's like, oh my God, it's just, it catches you off guard and you're not ready for it. And then there's some that are just absolutely heartwarming and you just, you gotta share them. And so we tried to pack those into this service today. I hope that today blessed you deeply. I hope that it let you know how beautiful and remarkable you are. And I just pray that you really grasp the value and the importance of forgiving, of letting it go, of not carrying it forward, of leaving it on the trash heap of history, and stepping forward into that next dimension for your experience. You deserve a good life. And the one who hurt you the one who let you down, does not deserve any element of your energy right now. Any element of it. Oh, yes, 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 yes. I'm affirming that you heard it, that you received it, and that it's sticking to you like glue. And so we didn't have a close this week because the video got cut off. So I'm gonna close the way that Reverend Della would. I place you lovingly in the hands of God. For only God has enough love to watch between us while we are absent from one another. And only God has that peace that surpasses all understanding. And so I bless you right now to receive that peace and that comfort and that understanding. Go forward, letting go, forgiving, forgetting, and letting it go. God bless you. Someone told you late enough.